Barossa Freedom activists have once again come out to face the media after being silent for over 4 months. This time around, the Barossa Imulemas, a youth pressure group under the Barossa National Freedom Alliance, have complained over accusations that, together with their leader, Clemence Nyinda, are planning to sabotage the forthcoming Zambian presidential by-election. The youths are also accused of planning to assassinate senior police officers and top government officials in Western Province. It is also alleged that the youths are planning to set ablaze government infrastructure. In the morning of November 24, 2014, the youths tried to meet Provincial Minister Rachel Siamunene to petition the police over the accusations, but did not meet him as he is out of office.
We are a peaceful people. We are a peaceful people. We want to assure, everybody living in Barossa land. We are not here for violence, and we are not going to do it. The little building that, the little infrastructure that we have in Barossa land is to make sure that we ensure, have to ensure that we protect them, not to destroy them. And there won't be any violence of any kind. Unless maybe the security wings have any hidden agenda purporting violence themselves. Otherwise, for the youths in Barossa land, all what we need is peace.
Lutang Sinonge is BNFA National Chairperson.
The Barossa National Council, Article number 8, they stated that Barossa land has reverted back to its original status, meaning now it's a sovereign state, which is supposed to, to have its own mandatory status that they are supposed, even the Zambian people are supposed to respect. It's not somewhere to state whether Zambia should conduct their election here, but the people of Barossa know their status. They are already a country, and we are just waiting for the final judgment that will come from Benju.
The struggle for Western Province between the Zambian government and the Barossa activists continues. Lloyd Kapsa, Move TV News, Mongu, Western Province.